Hey guys, so today I'm joined with my dad. I know we're gonna do the dad does my makeup video, but this is all I managed to rope him into, a question and answers. So maybe if this video gets enough shares and likes, he will do that video with me one day. So for those of you who live overseas, my dad was a weather presenter in New Zealand for what?
25 years.
I'll just insert a little clip of his last night on air now so you can get like a feel for his kind of job and what he did.
Hello everybody, welcome. Sun dried the washing in the north and the east and south, but humidities of 80% sapped the festive spirit over the top half. Now the rain's falling on the west coast and the upper north is back in the dishwasher late tomorrow. A long shot, but Christmas Day is looking pretty darn good. But right now, it's 6 o'clock. Good night, have a happy Christmas. I'm going to miss you all.
Oh, we're going to miss you, Jim. But hang on, just before you head off into the sunset, we can't let you go without a little tribute on your illuminating career.
Still love that jacket. Yes, we're sure you'll all agree. Jim, well, he's a legend, isn't he? He's been a shining light of weather presenting on television, beaming into all of our homes for 26 years. Have a look at this, you're going to love it.
First, the national weather scene with Jim Hickey. A little rain in Auckland today, but what about the rest of the country?
Well, our picture shows us that those of you in western areas continued to get some rain today. 60 millimetres over 4 days. How much is that? That much.
Basically, we've got an anti-cyclone stationary over Tasmania, a big one.
If you're like me, right now you'll be thinking about summer.
Beautiful.
Well, how about this one? Tēmata whakatangi hanga, ko o'o, a tamatea pokai, whenua ki tāna tahi. I left a little bit of my lower intestine, I think, up there. The smiles returning to the faces. It was the last cheeky little polar rodent that came out of the Southern Ocean and stung the bottom of the South Island, but it's not going to last long. There's a nice fat little anticyclone coming. She's facing southeast. The rain is actually coming from the northeast, so obedience classes are good. Crayfish. Kai Kora. These are the bad boys. Bad boys, bad boys. What you gonna do? We're out in the Tasman and we're gunning for you. Remember that? Well, that's what they're doing. I'm running out of things to say. It's back to you guys.
Jimmy. Bad boy, bad boy.
For you, bad boy.
Yeah, thank you, Gil.
Yeah. It's been a fantastic experience working with Jim. He is an absolute legend and he's done.
So as you can see, he was quite a well-liked figure and that's why it's been requested for us to do a question and answers. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoy getting to know my dad a little bit more. I asked you guys on Facebook and Twitter for some questions, so let's just get into it. Holly Barker wants to know, what's your dad's favourite thing about you?
Sally was low maintenance driving, to use a car analogy. She was just pretty much like you see her now. She was a very cruisy little girl, trouble-free motoring, and just a spontaneous smile and pretty much faultless, which is pretty rare for Dad to say about any of his kids.
Only because they had such a good dad, of course. Pickled Luke wants to know, what's the one thing that the other does that annoys you? So this is a question for both of us.
Annoyance is probably too strong a word. When she locks on to a conversational piece, there's no stopping her. She's a bit of a piranha when it comes to just making a point. And if you want to sort of interject and come up with a sort of maybe a little counter argument, she just carries on, mate. She's just like a little tank that rolls right over top of you in the nicest possible way. Yeah, she's pretty determined. That's probably why she's done so well.
It's funny, I was going to say the same kind of thing about you, because like when Dad thinks he knows best and he knows something, and that's the way you've got to do it. And that should be like, that's how it should be with most dads, but still, obviously, sometimes I get frustrated. I'm like, no, Dad, this is the new way. And he's like, nope. This is the way we're doing it. Amy Momassi, hope I'm pronouncing that right, wants to know, was I a planned pregnancy, and describe when you first saw me when I was born.
Sally was a late arrival on the scene, because I'd been married many years before I met Sally's mother, and I had three other children who were well into their teenage years when I met Sally's mum and we got married. And for me, it wasn't a plan, I say very selfishly, it was not a planned pregnancy, because I kind of had my kids, Sally's mum Sue, hadn't had any children, and she desperately wanted a little girl. So she kind of hoped and prayed, literally prayed real hard. And one day, miraculously, she fell pregnant. And here's the result. And dare I say, pretty cool. We're pretty happy with
that. Dad was like, would have liked another son, but you know. This is a question for you. Could you tell me what the word contour means? And then it says, Sally, don't give him any clues. Let him guess.
Contour. Well, contour means a line denoting shape. Because ooh, as a geographer, you know, so you have contour lines on a map showing you what the height was. Woman has, I've heard guys say, hey, check the contour on that. Another application.
Don't be gross.
Contour is a gym. Is it a gym place? Contour?
It is, yes. But I'll give you a hint. It's a makeup term. So I'm going to contour my face. You pretty much hit the nail on the head.
Make some lines where you're going to do stuff.
Yeah. I'll give you that. Remember at makeup room at TVNZ, they'll put some dark stuff down here and some light stuff up here.
That a fair bit to do on me falling in the cracks.
Chelsea Davies wants to know, to Sally's dad, what was the naughtiest thing Sally ever did?
That's a very interesting question because in the light of what we've already said, she didn't have a lot of flaws. But, you know, I'm a big M&M's peanut fan.
And
years ago we got one of those. There was an M&M dispenser, and I was like a little M&M man with a hand, and you could...
I remember it,
pop the, I don't know, didn't they come out
you
his
like
hand?
You like cranked the hand and they rolled out.
They rolled out, yeah.
Yeah.
And one day the house got very quiet and couldn't find Sally. And she'd hidden behind the wardrobe door, and she was troughing out on the M&M's. As you're chocking them out of mouth, like, oh, it wasn't me, you know. So you wouldn't really call that naughty, but it was kind of, was a gotcha sort of a moment,
you know. I vaguely remember that. I think I was really young, what, like 3 or something?
Yeah.
Super young, but I really remember it because I got a smack on the hand, like just the tiniest little tap, but to me it was horrible because I never got in trouble, and I cried and cried. No.
You didn't look that well for a little while.
Not really. Maybe it's when my chocolate obsession started. What would be an embarrassing moment Sally did as a toddler? That's probably the M&M thing.
M&M's. Oh, and as another one, actually.
Oh, no.
It was more of a shock surprise as opposed to an embarrassment. But when she went to primary school, she was in the school musical. Remember that, you know,
at Willow Park. Yeah.
And she's come home. How old were you? About 6 or something? 7?
I think I was a bit older. I think I was like 8. Yeah.
Yeah, oh, that's nice. And then the school put it on. It was a big fanfare. And we came along on the opening night. Just, you know, to be honest with you, I get bored with that stuff. But we supported her because we wanted to be there just for her. And I thought, oh, I'd be a little two-bit part in a chorus somewhere in the back far right-hand corner. And when the curtains pulled, the whole pack full of parents and families, Sally was kind of standing in the middle of the stage. And I was saying to myself, get back, get over there, go and hide in the corner somewhere, don't make a fool of yourself. She had the lead. She had the lead part in the school play, and she never told us. She did them. So not so much embarrassing, but I was just dumbstruck, you know. I couldn't believe my little girl. She was it. She was a leading lady.
I don't even know why. Like, I don't remember. I just didn't think it was a big deal. Whereas now I can never, ever get on stage and, like, sing in front of however many 100 people it was. But, like, when I was 8, I just didn't care at all. I just got up there and, like, sung some songs and danced around.
As you do.
And then question for me, Sally, what are some of the great inspiring qualities your dad has that you think about and look up to? Definitely humility, I would have to say. He's taught me to, like, always stay humble, and everyone's just a person. Every job is just a job, you know. You just got to be hardworking at what you do. And also, like, determination. Like, he didn't always want to be cranking out long hours at work, but he had to do it to, like, support us and everything. So he's taught me a lot of good skills about, like, perseverance and just, yeah, a lot of good qualities in life.
Thank you, mate.
It's okay.
I didn't score up on that. She just
straight from the heart.
Yeah.
Nicole Ashby said, for your dads, this one's for you, what did you think of Sally's YouTube channel when you first found out?
You know, she was at university doing a communications degree, and I was thinking to myself, YouTube, you know, and I'd seen a bit, obviously some of the YouTube clips are so corny, so contrived, so crazy. Others are very clever and funny, obviously.
Yeah.
I suppose, knowing how hard it was to get my university degree years ago, I was determined really, and I know retrospectively how much it means. I never really used it. I did a bachelor's degree in geography and majored in climatology, although it did help me with the weather job, obviously. I just wanted her to get there, and she, halfway through, the YouTube thing started getting busier, and I used to say to her, forget about all that YouTube stuff, just get your degree and do that later. Now I'm saying to her, forget about the degree, just give the YouTube stuff heaps, because She's my superannuation scheme to look after when I get older.
And for both of us, what is our favourite memory together? I was going to say, I mean, we've got so many good memories, really, but one that comes to mind for me is every, I don't know if it was Saturday or Sunday, because I was quite young, but Dad used to make me spaghetti and sausages on toast. I had a little pink plastic table, and we would go and eat on it, and he would be like hunched over like this. And we did it for what, like years? Like, it was just our weekend tradition, and it was like, so good to look forward to during the week because I wouldn't see him a ton because he'd be like working nights and stuff, and it was just like our special time together, and it's always a memory I will cherish.
Yes, Sally said the same for me. So many, you know, watching her learn to ski. And Sally wasn't a girl who was big on sport and stuff. I played a lot of sport, and so did Sally's mother. She was more a little girl at home, sort of dolls and books
arts and
stuff.
Arts and crafts. Yeah, arts and crafts.
But you know, she's got a real thread of real steel through her because, you know, once in Queenstown, which is the adventure capital of New Zealand in the South Island, we were up on the side of the mountain and there was a guy, there's a business here doing what they call paraponding, which is really like, parachuting off the top of a mountain. And Sally said, I don't like to do that. And I said, Sally, you're a little girl, you know, you can't do that. You know, that's a man's thing, you know. She said, no, I want to do it. We found the guy who ran the business. So she strapped the harness on. And the guy said, Sally, when I say run, you've got to run down that hill off the side of the mountain. And then when I say lift your feet, lift them up. And we'll sweep off the mountain. And of course, my heart was, and Sally's mother was, oh, should we let her do this? We let her do it. And she just took off down the side of the mountain and soared out 2,000 feet above Queenstown. And I was just real proud of her. I thought, man, this girl's got some, she got some guts.
Do you think Sally should get into being the weather lady?
I'm sure if she did, she'd do a great job of it, Erin. I don't know whether it's really...
I just don't know enough about weather.
Yeah, you kind of got to have a little bit. Oh, I could school her up a bit. Maybe we'll just see. It's an option if she gets tired of doing this, which I'm sure she won't because she absolutely loves it, don't you, babe?
I do, yeah. And I have seen how hard it is being a presenter on television. So at least right now I'm happy doing what I'm doing, but I can see how people would find that funny if I was the weather lady.
American people that watch it?
Yeah, lots of American people.
I got a Chevy Camaro, as you say over there, so I like my V8. Here's another one for you. A lady wrote to me years ago and she said, I wrote to TVNZ and said, you tell that weatherman not to tell me to have a good day. Who does he think he is? I'll decide to have a good day or not, because one night I'd sign off and say, have a great day, see you tomorrow. Don't tell me to have a good day.
Even Dad got the haters. Emma McGilly said, do you have any other gorgeous and amazing children? That's my sister.
This is an in-house joke. I've got this two gorgeous daughters in Australia. Becky Hickey, who's a wonderful nurse in Sydney, and Emma McGilly, who's a happily married mother of two and a PR executive, Emma McGilly.
Hi Emma, shout out. Shout out to Luca and Zane, because I'm pretty sure they watch me sometimes. Yeah, Paul. Demi says, hi Jim, I miss you, ha ha.
Is that Demi? You're Demi. Hi Demi, miss you too, Demi.
Shannon's left me 3 comments, so you know, other YouTuber Shannon, my pal. She said, Jim, if you had to start a YouTube channel, what would you film about?
Oh man. Probably aeroplanes and American cars.
And
a bit of adventure stuff.
Demo, stuff.
Yeah, Top I had a car. Top Gear had a car show on TV years ago for TV1. We'll do with cars and maybe outdoor stuff, like a bit of sport and fishing.
And we'll chuck her in again since we like her. So she wants to know, what do you think about haters and hate comments? And did you ever have any yourself?
The faceless haters, you know, social media is like that. You can type out the most vicious stuff. And it's a global phenomenon. There's no two ways about it. And when Sally started getting a profile, albeit, you know, in terms of volume, much smaller than yours, but she started getting them pretty quick. But they're very few and far between, and they were quite vicious. A lot of it's just a sort of low-life, rock-dweller sort of nasty backbiter. A lot of it's spite, I think, and jealousy, obviously. Yeah. I got a bit of hate mail at TVNZ, definitely, and we all did. It could knock you around, but as the PR people and as the news bosses said in our environment, look, for every one of those you get, there's 100,000 people who really like you. I mean, the ratings prove that. Your ratings prove that you're doing a really good job. The tall poppy syndrome, and I'm sure you've heard about that. You know, you have a field full of beautiful flowers, and if one sticks up above the others, they go, well, who do they think they are? You've got to cut it off, you know. So they're always going to be there.
New Zealand's particularly bad for that, aren't they?
We are, because I think we're critical, but we're also strangely supportive. Look at the All Blacks when they won the World Cup.
Yeah.
You know, we love certain things, but if we're a little different.
But if someone in themselves, you can tell someone thinks they're doing well, that's when you think, oh no, they need to be taken down.
Yeah.
No one can be proud of, you know, it's like a very fine line.
That is the key.
Yeah.
You know, if you vaunt and puff yourself up and say, oh, look how cool I am, if you're a poser, and there are a few around, people want to take you off at the knees. I don't really have much of a problem with that. But if you've got talent and you work hard and you just put it out there, like, well, that's fine, go for it. There'll always be those that'll be jealous, as you know, but don't worry about them. They're just garbage. Don't worry about them. Santiago.
Constanza Colao Alvarado. I'm so sorry if I said
Constanza. Because they speak Spanish here. They speak Spanish for the rest of all of South America except Brazil, where they speak Portuguese.
Dad does this, he does little fun facts all the time.
Oh,
he's like, now, did you know?
Constanza, she from Santiago? Tierra del Fuego, down the bottom, that island of fire. It's down the bottom of, what's the question?
It is, for me, did your dad's career motivate you to start the YouTube channel? And I'm not gonna say directly, because I was always interested and passionate about makeup, and then seeing people in like the States and stuff do YouTube really inspired me to like, put my own content out there. But at the same time, Dad definitely taught me to be like articulate, well spoken. He helped me out with a lot of like speeches at school, presentations at uni, so he really did help me with like my presenting skills. Although it's a lot easier when you're like your own editor and stuff. I can just edit out when I muck up, but yeah, definitely in some ways, like indirectly it did. But that's our Q&A video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Thank you so much to Dad for being in it. He's been a really good sport. Take some time out of his day to come and film with me. So again, give it a big thumbs up if you enjoyed it, and hopefully, fingers crossed, if we share it enough, maybe we'll get Dad back one day. Hope you guys enjoyed it, and I'll talk to you again soon. Bye! Which I'm sure you guys know. So the silvery one is all kind of cool tone shadows, and then it's randomly got an apricot-y, peachy, champagne-y shade, which is really pretty. They come with a little double-ended applicator. One side is a sponge, which I'm not a big fan of, but the other side does have a brush, which is quite nice. And then the gold one is definitely more my kind of shade. It's mainly like rich, neutrally browns and golds. And I must say, I do like the packaging this year. Really, really sleek and contemporary. It's kind of got like a glossy